Guys, one more method also. Because you can use this equation where you can get the product over sum or otherwise. Let's do it in example two. We have two resistors in parallel. This resistor is 20 ohm and this is 5 ohm. We have to find the equivalent. So you can do this. R equivalent is equal. Take the larger resistor to the numerator. Then get the ratio 1:2 ratio. Okay, so smaller is to larger ratio 1:4. Get the sum of that. That's 1 plus 4. Then it will be 5. So 20 by 5, that's equal 4 ohms. Got the idea? So you get the ratio, you get the sum of it and divide by the larger resistance. So this way it will be convenient for you to simplify quickly. Okay. So from the third example, let's try. So this is 4, 4, 8, 6, 4, 8, 8 and 4. So you have to find the equivalent resistance between these two points, A, B. You get this answer? Check. Those who got the answer, raise hand. And if anyone has any doubt, let me know. Sarah, how about you? Have you got the answer? Iris. Okay, I already got this answer. Half moon. Okay, so here, up to this, most of you must be okay, right? Up to this, most of you must be okay. Now, you might find a problem whether to consider these two as series or to consider these two as series, right? So, Sarah, I think you have the same problem. Now, think, if you consider these two as series, how about this point B? Will you have that point or will you lose that point? If you consider these two as series, you will lose this point, right? Do you get it, Sarah? So, how should I consider now? I must consider these two as series. Then it is one and one parallel, it's half. Is it clear now? So what is this? This is a short circuit. So when we have a short circuit, this path doesn't have any resistance. Here we have a resistance. Which path will the current choose? The resistant path or the short circuit path? It's going to choose the short circuit path. Therefore, this resistor can be removed. The resistor is short circuit. The resistor is short circuit. Therefore, not considered. Let's write it here. The 8 ohm resistor is short circuit. Therefore, it can be considered if it was not present or removed. So what is the resistance of the path above? It's 20. And the resistance of path below? The path above is 20 and below these two, 18 over 1 is to 2, that's 3. 6, 6 plus 9, that's 15. Okay. Now, what is the R equivalent? What is the larger resistance here? Larger resistance is 20. Now, what is the ratio? Ratio is 3 is to 4, right? Ratio is 3 is to 4. What you have to do is you have to consider 1 is to ratio. Okay, 1 is to ratio. Therefore, this is 1 plus 4 by 3. Then R equivalent. R equivalent is equal 60 over 7. This is important. Okay, Saja, you must make this correction. Here, when we consider the ratio, if this is not 1, then we have to make it 1. This will be 1 is to 4 by 3. Then you will just get the sum. 1 plus 4 by 3 and then do the rest. So R equivalent is 60 by 7. Is everyone clear? How about Sarah and Shahana? Sarah, clear. So here, as you see, it's a little bit complex. Not actually complex, but we have a lot of resistors. So what you have to do is try to simplify maximum resistors in your mind. And after that, draw the system or the network where you can remember. You don't need to always do solve one resistor and draw. Solve one and draw. You don't need to do that. You can just solve a lot in your mind. After that, draw the equivalent circuit. Okay. So you got this answer. How about Saja and Sarah?
Example
7. Do you understand one thing? If current flows through a resistor, then only it can act as a resistor. Okay. Otherwise, it is not a resistor. It doesn't act as a resistor. Now, what can you tell about the current through this? Will there be a current through this? To have a current, if there should be a current, then there must be a potential difference. When you start from some point and come back to the same point, can you have a potential difference? No, right? Therefore, the current in this loop, I'll say I1. I1 is equal to 0. Therefore, we can omit the loop below. So just forget about this loop. You have to find the equivalent resistance only for this. RAB is equal to 2 ohms. Is it clear? How about the others? So can we find the equivalent resistance between A and B? So here we don't have a resistor. If we don't have a resistor, then we can consider this one as a short circuit. So short circuit means the potential over here and the potential over here is same. Okay. Okay. Here, these two points are short circuit. That means the potential over here and the potential over here is same. So, what can you tell about this 4 ohm and this 4 ohm? What type of combination is that? What is the type of combination across between these two 4 ohm? Are they in series or parallel or none of them? Series, parallel, or none of them. So just think, if it is in series, you should have the same current. Obviously, we won't have the same current flowing through them, right? The same current won't go through this. Therefore, it's not in series. How about parallel? To be in parallel, the condition is we should have the same potential difference. We should have the same potential difference. That means the end of the resistors must be connected to the same points. So look, this resistor is connected between green and this blue. And this 4 ohm resistor is also connected between green and blue. So they have the same potential difference. Therefore, we can consider these two to be in parallel. Got it? How about Shahama? Do you get the idea? Can you all solve? See if you have got this number. Okay. Sarah, did you understand that? Okay, are you clear how I got 6 ohms here? Okay, so here, Sarah. This 2 and 2 is in series or parallel. these two are in series, therefore 4. This 4 and this 4 is in parallel, therefore 2. So similarly, here it's 2 and here also it's 2. Okay. So all those 2s are in series. That is how I got this 6. Is that clear? So are you clear with this 6? And how about this 3? These two together, it's 6. 6 and 6, that's 3. Okay. Now look, are these two points different? No, right? They are the same points. Therefore, these two comes in parallel. That's how I got these 2. Now, these 2 points are same. I brought them together as a single point, and that is how I got 3, 6 and 2. Okay, clear. How about the others? All good. Raja.